I made an AI Telegram chatbot that can analyze images. I said, this is image of my fridge. What low carb food can I prepare from ingredients in my fridge? Give me three ideas. It gave me three ideas by analyzing the image of my fridge. I also gave it this design picture and said, give suggestions for improvement on this design. And then it gave me suggestions for improvement. You are an expert in evaluating car damage for auto insurance reporting. Please evaluate the damage seen on this image. And it's going to stream the response. You see the way ChatGPT streams it as it generates. So we have damage location, type of damage, etc. I asked it what kind of food this is, and it exactly described the kind of food this is. I also told it where is this place, and it recognized correctly it's Times Square. Now it's not gonna recognize any random forest, but it knows the more familiar, more popular places. I also gave it a sequence of three images. Now this looks like the guy is punching this guy, but GPT is kinda pacifistic, so it said like the sequence of images and the guy is touching the other guy. I also gave it this image and said who is on this image and what is he doing. It doesn't want to provide real names of people. This is Jensen Huang, CEO of Nvidia, but it wants to say like the man on the image appears to be presenting a product. It also has text to speech. So I said /TTS and then gave it this text.
I am AI chatbot that has GPT-4 vision, GPT text generation, text to speech, speech to text, and image generation.
We can also generate images with /image and then the description of the image. It also should be able to transcribe our...
1, 2, 3, 4, you should be able to transcribe this.
It should be able to transcribe, but there is a bug right now. I'm gonna fix this. Over the next week, I'm gonna be fixing all of the bugs, and you can report all of the bugs. I'll show you how. There is also /buy command. It's gonna give me a few options to buy. This is $7 by $5, $20. This is a bit unorderly. I messed this up, but this is my fault. But anyways, there is also a table where we keep track of everything. So there is user ID, Telegram username, and then my available budget. Every time I spend, I do something, it's gonna subtract a bit from this budget. Now I will show you how to set this up very easily in 5 to 10 minutes. Number one, you're gonna go to the first link in the description, and it's gonna this one, the reply.com, and you're gonna click fork here, and then we can just name it fork or whatever, doesn't matter. So I'm gonna fork my REPL. So this is all of the code for this chatbot. Then you're gonna click this manage secrets. So we need to configure a few secrets here. So we're gonna click this edit as JSON. So if you don't see the secrets, you can find it on the left side here, edit as JSON. Then you're gonna go to the second link in the description. So that's gonna be my GitHub page. And this is gonna be the full GitHub of the full project. So you can read about documentation here, but you're gonna go here to this file .env.example. And you will copy this first part in these brackets. You will just copy that. Each of these configurations, you can read down below what each of them does. And here we're gonna just control A, or you can just delete everything and paste this new. So here we have all of the configurations, but we're gonna have to configure these ourselves. Then you will go to platform.openai.com/api-keys, and you will create a new secret key. You can call it Telegram, and then create a new key. You need to go into settings and billing, and you need to add your credit card here if you're gonna be able to use vision models, and you wanna be able to buy some credits, I'm pretty sure, or it's not gonna work. Just buy like $0.50 of credits or something. So now that you have your API, OpenAI API key, we're gonna paste it here. Let me move my camera to the other side. So the API key is here on this menu, and settings and billing is here. Then we are going to go to Telegram, and you can go to this web.telegram.org to open Telegram on web, and you can just you need to message this guy, botfather. So his username is @botfather. You need to message him. You need to press start, and it's gonna, you can say slash new bot. We need to create a new bot. And how are you going to call it? Just say AI persona, it doesn't matter. And then the username, AI persona, I think it must be unique. I'm gonna just give it some numbers here, and then it must end with bot. Okay, so this is our access token. So we're gonna copy this token, and you need to hide this because anybody will be able to control your bot through this. So this will go into Telegram bot token inside of these quotes. Then you wanna go ahead and message this guy, user info bot. As soon as you message him, he's gonna give you your like ID, and you wanna go back to Replit, and you wanna paste admin user IDs. This is gonna paste your ID here, so you are the admin or whoever. You can add multiple IDs here to make multiple admins. They're not gonna have any restrictions, or they actually will, never mind. So just paste it here if you want. Then back to bot father, I'm gonna say slash my bots. And then we will gonna, oh wait, what is this? Okay, we're gonna use choose our bot that we just created. And we are going to say payments. And we're gonna accept Stripe. And first we're gonna connect test Stripe, but you're gonna do the same for live. So we're gonna connect test Stripe. And we're gonna authorize and we're gonna open. So you're gonna connect to your Stripe account, but because this is testing, we can just press skip this form. Then we can go back to bot father. And it should, yeah, it gave us the Stripe ID. So we're gonna copy this Stripe ID. And we will go back to our Replit and payment provider token is gonna be this Stripe ID that we just got. And the last step is just to go to the Airtable link that I gave in the description of the video. So this is, you're gonna create a new account if you don't have Airtable. We will save our data here, our users and stuff. So you are going to click copy base. I'm not sure why I don't see here option to copy the base, but or if you cannot copy this base for some reason, add it to your Airtable. You're gonna create a new table. You need new base. You need first new base and then you need new table. Table is gonna be called budgets. And then you need the following files. User ID is gonna be number. The type is gonna be number. And then Telegram user ID type number. Telegram username type text, single line text. Available budget type number. Total budget by now, we actually don't need this, but total budget by now number. And then usage tracker JSON long text, but I don't think we need it. But make sure to just add these. If you have any issues, comment below. You need this exact table. And then when you enter that table, we're gonna see this first part of the link between these slashes. So the first part, this code of the link, this is going to, we're gonna copy that and go back. This is gonna be our Airtable base ID. And then go back to the Airtable. And then the second part, the second, these scrambled letters between second slashes are gonna, is gonna be our Airtable table ID. Then we will click to our icon here and then we're gonna say developer hub. And then we will say API keys, personal access tokens. And we will create a new token and we will call it Telegram chatbot, for example. Scopes we need are data records read and data records write. Access base, let's just say all current. I don't know why it's showing now. So this is what one we need. So we can remove this all current bases. And then we're gonna create this token. Token name must be unique. Okay, maybe it's not unique. So this is our token and we're gonna copy it and then press done. You will never be able to see this again. If you need a new token, just generate a new token and Airtable API key goes here. So let me just copy this. This is our configuration done. I'm just gonna press save. I messed up the recording a little bit. So after that, just press run. And we're gonna wait for a few moments here. As you can see, it's doing something. It's starting, application started. Now go to our Telegram into our bot father and click this. You need to click this link so you can message your bot or just message it. As you can see, I already messaged it. Hi, but I messed up the recording. So I'm gonna message it again. And hi, hello, how can I assist you? Like, so it works, let me send a photo. I'm just gonna say, describe this image, send. We're gonna wait for a few moments and it is working. This is Space Needle. Now let me check our Airtable. So we can go back to airtable.com and we can enter our table, our base, which is this one for me. And we can see that we have our budget. Now, if you want to completely restart everything, you're gonna have to stop it. You need to go here and delete this row, delete this record. And also, you wanna go here, usage logs, and you need to delete this usage log. You need to delete that as well because it's gonna be buggy. I'm gonna fix this bug, but for now you wanna delete this. And now there is no user, there is no usage logs. And now if you run again, we are going to go into our chatbot. I'm just gonna say hi again, it doesn't matter. It should add me automatically here, yes. Okay, let me now also show you additional settings you can have here. So if you go to your secrets and edit as JSON, so for example, payment options, these are the payment options. If you need to put them like this, comma separated values, $5, $10, $20, exactly like this must be. Then a free trial budget. So as you can see, when it added me here, it gave me $1 free trial because I set that to be here. You can go here and edit manually. Okay, this subtracted because it was sending the message. So you can edit this manually. It's gonna be like, you can give anybody whatever you want budget. Now, this is important. You wanna adjust your token prices. So you wanna go to OpenAI pricing. Click this first link. This is how much you will be paying to the OpenAI. These are the prices here. So you wanna have a bit maybe more expensive prices. So for example, GPT 3.5 Turbo, you're gonna be paying this. So you wanna charge a bit more so you get some profit. Here you are paying 0.4 per Dolly 3. So you're gonna charge 0.45, for example. This pricing, you can read everything in my GitHub. So here in this GitHub link, you can read all of the everything explained. But basically, if you choose Dolly 2 here, you can say Dolly 2, and then you can say image size. So this is, there are three image sizes for Dolly 2. This is 256 by 256. This is 512 by 512, and this is 1024 by 1024. But this is nuance. If you are using Dolly 3, it must be this, and it's always gonna use this price. So you just need to know this. I'm gonna make this more intuitive, but for now it works like that. And then these prices, vision token price, transcription price, they are I just increased them a little bit from this pricing. So you're gonna be paying to the OpenAI this price, but you're gonna be making some profit. You can actually enable, disable image generation, text to speech, transcription, etc. Stream true means basically if it's gonna stream the reply to the Telegram chatbot, it's gonna write the message as it generates, or if it's false, it's gonna just wait for the entire message to be generated and then send the entire message at once. Max tokens is the length of the message. Max history size is the number of previous messages that it's looking into when generating. So the more previous messages, the longer context window, but it's also gonna be more expensive. And this one is important. Enable vision follow-up questions. If you set this to true, after you send an image, it's going to keep using the GPT-4 image. So you can ask more like questions about that image without sending the image again. But if you set this to false, then after you send the image, it's gonna answer with GPT-4 vision, but for the next message, it's gonna answer with GPT-3.5. So it's not gonna be able to see the image. If you wanna be able to follow up with additional conversation after you send the image for next messages, you leave this a true, but you're gonna pay a bit more. Write in the comments what you think. I'm gonna be upgrading this repository, this chatbot, and I'm gonna be making more videos for more use cases soon. I don't know if I skipped anything, but everything will be written in the first comment. I'm gonna write some notes in the first comment if you need to know anything that I forgot to say. So check the comments.